Hi, Millie. How are you? Where are you?
I'm doing fine. I'm at home in Kibra.
I'm so curious, what's your day-to-day routine like now that everything's shut down? How are you staying kind of stimulated and activated and engaged while you're locked at home?
There's this program that Lottie introduced for One Girl Can, and it's called Mentorship. Every year we normally fill in a mentorship worksheet, and that is to explain to them doing as a girl to, for other women or for other girls back in society. And through those 4 years of doing it, it has actually sunk in and it's in my blood. So whether or not we are filling the worksheet or not, it's in my system to just pass it on to the other girls, and which other girls if not my sisters. So that's what I've been doing.
I was thinking about the sort of one girl can model of, you know, there's the motto of we build, we educate, we mentor, but you are a really qualified person to speak on how that model works and how it's affected your life, those three sort of pillars of One Girl Can.
One Girl Can started me off as a little baby in the first year at my university. One Girl Can took me to school, but at the same time, One Girl Can provided an opportunity for me to get giant, confident woman that was hiding inside me come out. One Girl Can has been organizing yearly annual conferences where we get to go and we are encouraged in very beautiful ways by women who have gone before us and have become exemplary in what they do. Mm-hmm. One thing that these conferences teach me is that giving back is actually the way to keep the world moving. It has not just taken me to school. You have not just taken me to places in my mind that I never imagined I could go to, but it has sparked a new star in me that is slowly growing and growing, and I am very happy.
What do you think is going to happen after this is over? Like, what do you think life looks like for you and for Kenya?
What I know is going to change is people's mindsets and the decisions they make, you know? So the government's promised aid has not yet seen the doors of many people living in Kibra. So let's say 5 years to come, I'm in government, or I have some sort of way into the government. I know what's happening. So if another pandemic, God forbid, occurs or some other situation comes in, I know what kind of help that is needed here and I will bring it, you know. But that is exactly what One Girl Can does. Where you've helped and you've climbed up to the stairs, but you don't look down on your people. Because that is one thing that One Girl Can is doing, appreciating your society and where you came from. So I believe that people's mindset, especially my mind, has changed. I used to shy away from politics, shy away from government. But today, I want some part of that power to be able to make decisions.
Well, you were supposed to come to Canada in April. I was wondering if there was anything you in particular wanted the people watching this virtual fundraiser to know about you or your experience or One Girl Can or anything that you were going to share.
Yeah, thank you so much for this opportunity, Mackenzie. I really love to thank BD team. The BD team has been working with me through those 4 years, and the company has paid for everything I ever needed and wanted, for my school tuition, for any special funds that I needed. The reason this girl is smiling this wide and is going to give back to the society is because you stretched out your arms for me. And I say, thank you so much. Thank you. One Girl Can will never come to a stop. Whether we have the pandemic or not, we are still urging you to help us take girls to school, you know, because the pride of any nation is the women. So we are not going to disappoint you. We appreciate the help that you have given us so far. Thank you so much for helping us.
Same to you. It's so nice to see you, Millie.